You're probably better off staying here with me anyway, Lee. I'll take care of you, boy.
I don't need taken care of. Not by you anyway.
Well, come on, all this toast is almost ready.
I don't want any toast!
You can't just drink. How long have you been drinking, anyway?
Maybe it was Fresno. Hey. What was that area code for Fresno? How could I have lost that number? God, she was beautiful.
Come on, just forget about that, Lee. Just forget about the woman.
She had green eyes. You know what green eyes do to me?
Yeah, I know.
Then shut up.
You're not gonna get it on with her now, anyhow. It's dawn already. She's in Bakersfield, for Christ's sake.
Yeah. It's dawn.
Yep. Come on, let's just have us some toast and...
Hey! Hey! Now what is it with the toast? Huh? You are making that toast sound like salvation or something. I do not want, see it? No, do not want any goddamn toast. Now how many times have I got to tell you that?
Well, it is like salvation, sort of. The smell and everything. Oh, God, I love the smell of toast. Sun's coming up. It makes you feel like anything's possible, you know?
So go to church, why don't you then?
It's like a beginning. I love beginnings.
Well, I've always been kind of partial to endings myself.
What if I come with you, Lee? If I come with you out to the desert.
Are you kidding?
No. No, I'd like to see what it's like.
You wouldn't last a day out there,
Pat. Oh, come on! That's what you said about the toasters. You said I couldn't steal a toaster either.
A toaster has got nothing to do with the desert.
Look, I'm not that helpless, Lee. I can make it. I can cook.
Huh?
I can.
So what? You can cook. Toast.
No, I can make fires. I can get fresh water from condensation.
Hey, Austin, it's not something you learn out of Boy Scout handbook.
Yeah, well, how do you learn it then?
You just learn it. That's all. You learn it because you have to learn it. You don't have to.
No, you could teach me.
Are you crazy?
Huh?
You went to college.
Yeah,
here you are down here rolling in bucks, floating up and down in elevators, and you want to learn how to live on the...
Yes, yeah, I do, Lee.
There's nothing down here for me. There never was when we were kids here. It was different. There was a life here then. Now I keep coming down here like it's the 50s or something. I get off the freeway and familiar landmarks, they turn out to be unfamiliar. On my way to these appointments, I wander down streets I thought I recognized. They turn out to be replicas of streets I remember. Streets I misremember. Streets I don't know if I lived on them or if I saw them in a postcard. Fields that just don't exist anymore.
Well, there is no point in crying about that now.
There's nothing real down here, Lee. Least of all me.
Well, I can't save you from that.
Yeah, you can let me come with you. No, Lee, let me come with you.
Hey, now, do you actually think that I choose to live out in the middle of nowhere? Huh? Do you think it's some kind of philosophical decision I took? Boy, I live out there because I can't make it here. And here you are, bitching to me about all your success!
Lee, I'd cash it all in a second. Now that's the truth, please!
I can't believe it.
Let me come with you!
Stop saying that, will you? You are worse than a dog!
You want some toast?
Tell you what I'll do, little brother. I will consider making you a deal. Little trade lock. Now you wrap me up that screenplay thing. Just like I tell you, boy. I mean, you can use your usual tricks and stuff. Your fancy language. Your artistic hocus pocus. But you had better write down everything, like I say, boy. Every move. Because every time that they run out of gas, they'll run out of gas. If they want to jump on a horse, they will do just that. If they want to stay inside Texas, by God, they'll stay inside Texas. Now you finish up that whole thing for me. Top to bottom. You put my name on it. I own all the rights. And every dime goes in my pocket. No, you do all that for me. And I will sure enough take you with me to the desert. How does that sound? It's a deal.